Good evening, everyone. Yes, once again, we are back from BioPoint Stream the World of Bio with yet another session of biology for boards and need. The topic or the chapter that we are going to start today is plant growth and development, the very first lecture, and the topic of the day is plant growth. Yes, so after a long time, we are back right in front of you. So everyone, be cooperative in today's session. Due to certain inconveniences, we are taking a recorded session today. And hope you all are perfectly ready for the new chapter. Yes, so let's start with the full Josh. Reminding, if anyone new is watching this session, kindly join our Telegram group where you have the daily session updates, Telegram quizzes, and where you get the study materials and you have the mentor doubt clearance. The direct link to join the Telegram group is given there in the description box, and that is t.me/need_biopoint. Hope you all are ready. Yes, and this is what the success of BioPoint. We have these must toppers in the AISSE examination. Yes, hearty congratulations to each and every one of you who have scored this much better score in your AISSE examination. Yes, and one more thing to inform you is that some of you of your images or your scores as well as your name is not included in this poster because it was too late that you have submitted your photographs, but we will try to include it as soon as possible. Yes, so let's move on with today's session. Do hit the like button, share it with your friends and subscribe BioPoint Stream the World of Bio for further session updates. Let's start today's class. As we have discussed, the topic of the day is plant growth. So we are going to start today's session in the same way of starting with the topic plant growth. All plant cells are descendants of the zygotes. That is the fertilized egg. What is a zygote? Zygote is a fertilized egg. A zygote develops from a premature plant through growth and differentiation, forming roots, leaves, branches, flowers, fruits, seeds, and they eventually die. Yes, now we have learned two terms, that all the zygote develops into a mature plant through growth, the very first process, that is a growth. And after that, the new term, that is differentiation. So these are the two events that are happening in a plant growth, mainly in a plant growth and development. Yes. So now what we have to go understand is that how is growth occurring in plants? How is differentiation occurring in its cells? All those things are what we have going to complete in this today's session. Yes. So let's move on without wasting much time. We are here. So plant growth. What's a growth? As all of you know, growth is an irreversible, permanent increase in size of an organ or its parts of an individual. Yes, it is an irreversible permanent increase, because if one organism grown, we cannot reduce its growth. Yes, for example, if it is a non-living thing, such as due to the accumulation of substances, we may just hit it and destroy its surface, and such we can destroy the accumulated materials of its surface. But if it is a growth in a living material, it is an irreversible growth, right? If it is growth in case of a tree, can we reduce its growth? No. The only way to reduce is just to cut or to destroy that plant, right? So it is an irreversible permanent process, and that is determining whether the increase in size of an organ or any part of that body or an organism, any part of an organism or an individual cell. It may be an increase in size of an organ or its parts or an individual cell. It involves metabolic processes that consume energy. So growth involves certain biochemical activities that requires energy for its day-to-day activities, right? So let's move on without wasting much time here as well. We have studied the definition of growth, and after that we are moving with next topic, that is plant growth is generally indeterminate. Plant growth is generally indeterminate. How can we say that? Plant growth continues throughout the life due to the presence of meristem. So very important point, their growth is continuing throughout their life, all throughout their life. Yes, and these meristematic cells have the capacity to divide and self-perpetuate. What do you mean by capacity to divide and self-perpetuate? That is, this meristematic tissues, they continuously divide and new cells are further added to that tissue. Yes, and that is what is meant by self-perpetuation or an open form of growth in a plant. Okay, so plants have an open form of growth. Sorry, once again. Yes, plants have an open form of growth, that is, the new cells are added to its meristematic cells. The growth where new cells are always added to the plant body by the activity of the meristem is called as what? An open form of growth. Is it clear till now? All about the growth in the plant and whether the plant growth is indeterminate or determinate. Yes, plant growth is generally indeterminate. Why? Because growth can be seen only in respective parts of the plant, right? In respective cells or respective tissues of the plant. And what else is there? New cells are getting added to its meristems, and that is known as the open form of growth, and it is generally indeterminate. And what is in case of an animal cell or an animal growth? Animal growth is generally determinate. Is it clear? Animal growth is generally determinate. Why is it so? Because they have a closed form of growth, and their growth is seen over all parts of the body. Not like in specific parts as in case of a plant. Their growth is seen all over the body. And therefore, animal growth is said as a determinate growth and plant growth is said as what? An indeterminate growth. Yes? So that's about the what plant growth is. The topic plant growth is generally indeterminate. And after that, we are going to move about the next topic, that is primary growth and secondary growth. What is this primary growth and secondary growth? Primary growth refers to the elongation of plants along their axis. The growth that causes the elongation of plants along their axis is known as what? Primary growth. And where it is occurring? It is occurring in root apical meristem and shoot apical meristem. Yes, root apical meristem and shoot apical meristem are the two regions where primary growth is occurring. If you look here in this figure, you can see at the tip, you can see the shoot apical meristem. And at the lower tip, you can see the root apical meristem. In these two regions, what is occurring? The primary growth is occurring in these two regions. Is it fine? Is it fine? So the primary growth is occurring in these two regions. And then what in case of the secondary growth? Secondary growth implies that the increase in the growth that causes the increase in girth of organs, that is increase in width or girth. Yes, that is what is said as secondary growth. It is occurring mainly in case of gymnosperms and dicots, and it is due to the lateral meristems, vascular cambium and core cambium. These are the two three regions that mainly enables secondary growth. Yes, so hope that too is clear about primary growth and secondary growth. If you look here, the vascular cambium that causes what? The secondary growth, or that enables or that allows the process of secondary growth. Is that clear? So primary growth causes the elongation of plants and secondary growth causes the increase in girth of the organs. Yes, that's fine. Okay, so let's move on. Give me thumbs up on the screen if it's perfectly clear till now. I will give you 10 seconds for that. Give me thumbs up on the screen. Do it as fast as possible. Thank you so much for your responses. So let's move on. Today, next topic is the growth is measurable. Why it is said that growth is measurable? Growth at cellular level occurs due to the increase in amount of protoplasm. So the increase in the amount of protoplasm is what is said as the growth at the cellular level. Yes. So it is difficult to measure the increase in protoplasm directly. So it is measured by certain conditions or parameters like the increase in their fresh weight, increase in their dry weight, their increase in length, volume, area, cell number, all those things are the certain parameters that are used to identify whether a plant has grown or not. Yes, whether a plant has grown or not is determined by certain parameters such as increase in fresh weight, dry weight, length, area, volume, and cell number. Yes, so we can say that an instrument is used to measure the plant growth. And such an instrument is known as what? The auxanometer. Auxanometer, and that is an instrument that is used to measure the plant growth each day. Yes, each day. Growth of plants can be measured in each 24 hours with the help of an auxanometer. Yes, with the help of an auxanometer. Okay, so after that, we have said about some of the criteria, that is cell number, how we can differentiate the growth. Maize root apical meristem can produce 17,500 new cells per hour. Very important. So per hour, how many new cells can be produced by a maize root apical meristem? A maize root apical meristem can produce 17,500 new cells in an hour. Yes, cell size, that is in case of a watermelon, may increase 350,000 times. Yes, they may be increasing by 350,000 times. Length, how we can, what is an example for the growth in length or increase in length? That is the growth of a pollen tube, that is elongating. Yes. Elongating and reaching the ovary. And that is how increase in length of a pollen tube occurs. And surface area, that is growth in a dorsiventral leaf. If you can see, when the leaf grows, its surface gets broader. And that is an example for the increase in surface area. Is it fine? Is it fine about that? And that's an example for growth is measurable. Yes. So we have said about the growth in cellular level is due to the increase in amount of protoplasm. And after that, we have said about the different parameters that are used to measure the growth. And after that, we have said about the auxanometer and how such a growth is measured in case of an auxanometer. And after that, we have discussed about how different criteria, examples of different criteria and how is they applicable in case of a plant growth. Okay, so the next topic is phases of growth. What all are the phases of growth? All of you know that the plant growth or the period of plant growth can be divided into three main phases. Am I right? They can be divided into three main phases. The very first one is the meristematic phase. Second one is the elongation phase. And third one is the maturation phase. Yes, meristematic phase, elongation phase and maturation phase are the three phases of growth in a plant. Yes. So what is this meristematic phase, elongation phase and maturation phase? All those things are what we are going to learn in the upcoming slides. Yes. So meristematic phase, that is, it is occurring at the root apex and the shoot apex. Yes. So the cells present in the meristematic region are rich in protoplasm and have a large nuclei. Their cell walls are primary, thin and cellulosic with abundant plasmodesmatal connections. So these are the most important points that you have to understand from the meristematic phase. Yes. So look in this figure, you can see the phases A and B given here can be determined as the meristematic phase. And what all things are happening there? In that phase, they have their cell wall is primary and they have a thin cellulosic cell wall. Yes. And they have a large nuclei, which is, their cells are rich in protoplasm as well. Yes. And where are they found? They are found at the tip of the root and the tip of the shoots. Yes. That is in the root apex and the shoot apex. So that is all about the meristematic phase. Is it clear? Is it clear till now? Give me hearts on the screen. I will give you 10 seconds again for that. Yes, thank you so much. So let's move on with elongation phase. What is elongation phase? It is a condition of a cell that has increased evacuation size and they have new cell wall deposition. Yes, their vacuoles will be increased and their size will be increased and they will be having more depositions in their cell wall. Okay, so in this figure, do comment which all alphabets denotes the elongation phase. Which all alphabets in this figure denotes elongation phase? Do comment it as fast as possible. By the time I will explain elongation phase. Yes, elongation phase occurs in cells that is next to the next away from the tip. Okay, cells that are just away from the tip are the places where elongation phase is seen. Okay, so that is from this figure we can identify C and D are the phases that are just above the meristematic phase, and that too are the places or regions where elongation is occurring. Yes, so that's as well in case of elongation phase. We could move on with the next one, that is the maturation phase. What is the maturation phase? That is, it occurs in the cells further away from the apex, that is more proximal to the phase of elongation. That is cells that are somewhat above or present more above the phase of elongation is referred to as the maturation phase. That is here the alphabets G, F and E denotes maturation phase. Yes. So at that phase, what happens? The cells attain maximum in their size. That is in terms of wall thickening, protoplasmic modifications, etc. In all these cases, the cells attain their maximum in their size. Yes. That's all about the three different phases of growth: meristematic phase, elongation phase, and maturation phase. Yes, we have a bit more topic, that is growth rate and the conditions. Yes. So let's move on without wasting much time. So is it clear till now? Is it clear till now? Do comment it. Okay, so let's move on with the next topic, growth rate. So what is a growth rate? It is the increased growth per unit time. Increased growth per unit time is denoted as a growth rate. Yes, so the rate of growth can be expressed mathematically, and they are of mainly of two types, that is an arithmetic growth rate and geometrical growth rate. If we look here, you can see that diagram 1 denotes the arithmetic growth rate and figure B denotes the geometric growth rate. So what is the difference between this arithmetic growth rate and the geometrical growth rate? Yes, what is the difference between all these cases? So let's learn that. Yes. One second. So in case of an arithmetic growth rate, what is happening? You can see a single cell over here. What happens is that this cell divides into two. Yes. And from that, what happens? One of the cell divides and one differentiates. For example, look here. This cell divides into two. Yes. And what happens next? This cell divides into two. One here, one here. Okay. In the same way, the cells again divides into two. One does not grow and one further divides. Such a division is known as what? Arithmetic growth rate. So let's explain with the help of this figure. If you look here, in this case, you can see what is happening right here. Look, there is a single cell dividing into two. Yes, from that divided cell, what happens? Only one cell divides into two and one differentiates. Yes, in the same way, another cell, set of cell divides into two and the next one differentiates. Yes, in the same way is occurring in the next division as well. That is what occurring in case of an arithmetic cell division or arithmetic growth rate. Yes, one cell is present that is dividing into two, one and two. Yes, which where one further divides into two. Yes, imagine these are the two cells and one what happens differentiates. Yes, here as well, it divides further again into two. Yes, these two cells differentiates. Yes, that's all in case of arithmetic growth rate. Then what is geometric growth rate? Geometric growth rate, what happens if a single cell is dividing into two? Yes. What happens? This further divides into two. This further divides into two. Yes. In the newly formed cell, this also divides into two. This also divides into two. This also divides into two. And this as well divides into two. That is how a geometric growth rate is happening. Yes, there is no differentiation in case of a geometrical growth rate. Yes. So let's discuss in detail what all are this arithmetic growth rate and geometric growth rate. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 slides more. Okay. We have 6 slides more. Yes. Hope each and everything that I'm explaining right now is clear for you. Arithmetic growth rate. In this, the following mitotic cell division, only one daughter cell continues to divide, whereas the other differentiates and matures. Yes. The another cell, what happens to that? It just differentiates and undergo maturation. That is, it stops dividing. On plotting the length of the organ against time, a linear curve is obtained. You can see a straight line when such a graph is plotted. When arithmetic growth rate is plotted, you can see a linear curve in the graph. Yes, and how can we express this in mathematical method? The formula to find or the expression of arithmetic growth rate is Lt is equal to L0 plus Rt, where Lt denotes the length of time t. Yes, L0 denotes the length at time 0 and R denotes the growth rate or elongation per unit time. Is it clear? So arithmetic growth rate, when you are obtaining that such a curve in a graph, what is obtained? A linear curve is obtained. And what is the mathematical expression? Lt is equal to L0 plus Rt is the mathematical expression, where Lt is the length at time t. L0 is the length at time 0 and R implies the growth rate or elongation per unit time. So what is in next in case of geometric growth rate? Geometric growth rate, both the daughter cells continue mitotic cell division. Yes, in most systems, the initial growth is slow, also known as the lag phase. Then it increases rapidly or log or exponential phase. If nutrient supply is limited, the growth slows down, leading to a stationary phase. Yes, that's about in case of geometric growth rate. So let's discuss that. So if you are obtaining this geometric growth rate in a graph, what is this autocorrection? So if you are obtaining such a thing in a graph, wait 1 second, and taking size or weight of the organ in the y-axis and time in the x-axis, how such a graph can be obtained? We can see a sigmoid curve. Yes, we can see a sigmoid curve. Initially, we can see a lag phase where growth is very slow. Then we can see a period of vigorous growth known as the log phase or exponential phase. And after that, a period where the growth slows down, known as the stationary phase. Is it clear? That's about the graph in case of a geometric growth rate. So let's discuss with the help of this slide. So on plotting growth against time, we get a sigmoid or S curve. Yes. So look here, you can see the graph right here. A sigmoid curve is a characteristic of living organism growing in a natural environment. It is typical for all cells, tissues, and organs of a plant. So how this geometric growth can be explained, growth rate can be explained mathematically. So they can be expressed mathematically in the following equation, that is W1 is equal to W0 plus ERT. So where W1 is indicating the final size or the weight or height or number, etc. W0 indicating initial size, that is at the beginning, what was the size at the beginning. Yes, R indicating the growth rate. What growth rate here? It is determined as the relative growth rate in case of geometric growth rate. Yes, and T indicating time of growth and E indicating base of natural logarithms. Yes, E is indicating the base of natural logarithm. So here you can see the growth is lagging here. Yes, and here what happens, there is a period of vigorous growth and stationary phase growth stops. Yes. So that's about the geometric growth rate. So let's discuss about the relative growth rate. So what is relative growth rate? Here R is the relative growth rate as per the equation we have what said right now. It is the measure of the ability of the plant to produce a new plant material. Okay, ability of a plant to produce a new plant or a new offspring is referred to as the relative growth rate, also known as efficiency index. Yes, and the final size W1 depends on the initial size W0. Right, when if there is only an initial particular size, we can complete the equation in case of the final size. Right, therefore final size W1 completely depends on the initial size. Is it clear? Fine. So quantitative comparison can be done in two ways. That is absolute growth rate and relative growth rate. So what is this absolute growth rate? Absolute growth rate indicates the measure and comparison of total growth per unit time. Yes, growth divided by unit time. And that is what is defined as AGR or absolute growth rate. Then what is RGR or relative growth rate? That is the growth per unit time, that is absolute growth rate divided by initial growth into 100%. That is what is said as relative growth rate. Yes, so measurement of growth of a given system per unit time expressed on a common basis per unit initial parameter is referred to as the relative growth rate. Is it clear? So let's find the difference in growth rate in this figure. So here you can see that diagrammatic comparison of absolute and relative growth rate, both A and B, leaves A and B have increased in their area by 5 cm² in a given time to produce A1 and B1 leaves. So let's discuss the difference in growth rate. Yes. So absolute growth rate in case of, that's the difference in absolute growth rate in case of leaf A, we are going to find right now. That is the total final growth, that is 10 minus the initial growth, that is 5. You can see 5 cm². That is the difference in absolute growth rate. So let's find the relative growth rate of leaf A. That is absolute growth rate divided by initial growth rate, that is 5 into 100%. What we will get? We will get 100% itself. Am I right? So if we are coming back to this case B, we can say absolute growth rate here in case of B is equal to 55 minus 50. Am I right? We'll get 5 cm² and relative growth rate is equal to 5 by 50 into 100%. Yes. Canceling into 2 and you will get 10% finally. Is it clear? This is how we are finding the difference in the absolute growth rate and the relative growth rate. So if it is perfectly clear till now, we could move on with the conditions for growth. Yes. Conditions for growth. Oh God, okay, fine. So the conditions for growth. The very first essential condition is that the presence of water. Water is very much required for the cell enlargement. Turgidity of cell helps in extension growth or elongation growth. Water provides the medium for enzymatic activities needed for growth. And that is how water is helping in plant growth. Is it clear? Is it clear? Next, in case of oxygen. What in case of oxygen? Oxygen helps to release metabolic energy for growth. Yes. So the after oxidation of this food materials or after releasing or further what reduction of this oxygen, what happens? This is utilized for the metabolic activities. So such an energy is got or received from the oxygen involved. Yes. So oxygen helps to release the metabolic energy for growth. Then in case of nutrients, what else in case of nutrients? Macro and micro elements are needed for the synthesis of protoplasm and act as a source of energy. Yes, for synthesizing of protoplasm, what is required? The different what nutrients of plants, such as nitrogen, phosphorus, all those things are required for the synthesis of protoplasm and it act as an energy. Is it clear? Yes, next is in case of temperature. Plants have an optimum temperature at which growth is maximum. Deviation from this range could be detrimental or detrimental to its survival. So if temperature is much higher, what happens? That requires in what results in the wilting of the plant, right? The temperature is lower also that requires that affects the growth of the plant. Yes, that is whether the transpiration conditions as well. So this temperature also plays one of the more determining role in case of plant growth. Next is light and gravity. Sunlight and gravity, how it is useful. It affects certain phases or stages of growth. For example, in case of photosynthesis, sunlight is required for the root to grow downwards. Gravity is required. All those things are different parameters that are essential for plant growth. Is it clear till now? Is it clear till now? That's all. Is it clear till now? And once again, reminding you, if anyone new is watching without subscribing to this channel, do subscribe it and do hit the like button, share it with your friends. And reminding again, subscribe to our channel, BioPoint, stream the world of bio. Yes. So that's all for today. It's me signing out from your favorite and my favorite BioPoint, stream the world of bio. Bye-bye.